Hey guys, for today I have a couple new lip balms from Pat McGrath Labs. These are the two new limited edition Lip Fetish lip balms. The line of lip balms isn't new, just these two shades are. So we have the Astral Blue Star and Noir. So these are $56 Canadian each or 40 US. You get 0.12 ounces or 3.5 grams. And I just want to note for Canadian pricing, these two shades specifically are $2 more than the other Lip Fetish lip balms. The other ones are $54. I like the packaging because it's just plain. I like anything plain. It's just matte black, so it looks really sleek. It's got a little bit of weight to it. I just like the plain matte black. It's pretty nice. I decided to try both of these out because I thought they looked very strange. Just the idea of like a gray lip balm and like a bluish lip balm, I was like, how can that look good, you know? But then I saw the pictures and it looked really flattering and just like normal. So I thought I needed to try them out. So first we have Astral Blue Star, which is a glittering iridescent. That's what they describe it as. I'm wearing it right now with nothing else underneath. I just want you to see how the lip balm looks on its own, just in case you're interested. But I do think this one would be a really nice lip topper because of the glitters. So yeah, it's just a sheer balm with tiny blue glitter flecks in it. On application, like just while I'm actually applying it, I can feel the glitters. It kind of feels a little bit gritty, but while I'm wearing it, like right now, I can't feel anything. It just feels like a regular old lip balm. This one is my favorite of the two just because of the glitters. They're blue, which I didn't think I would like, but they're really small and subtle, so it's still simple and pretty. The only thing, if like lip balm is something that I'm not very precise with, I just kind of put it wherever I feel like I need it, and so you can kind of get glitters around your mouth, so it looks a little bit off, but they're really tiny and it's not like a huge deal. And I mean, it's also easy to just not apply lip balm all around the perimeter of your mouth. Just saying, they can get a mind of their own and kind of just move slowly outwards to this general area. And then we have Noir, which is a sheer ebony. Now, just looking at this, I'm like, how would that look good on lips? How does that not make you look dead once you apply it? And then I did the hand swatch and it still looked really gray. I was like, that can't look good. But then once I put it on my lips, it just blends away to nothing. So it really is just clear once it's on your lips, and I can build it up and build it up and build it up, and it doesn't turn gray at all, which is kind of cool, but it's like just clear lip balm. Both of these, performance wise, I have nothing bad to say about them. But I have nothing great to say about them either. They're just a lip balm. They're comfortable on your lips. They do hydrate your lips. They stay on for the same amount of time as any other lip balm would. But if I was looking for like some deep hydration, I would still go for a lip mask, or even a couple of my other favorite lip balms are the Sol de Janeiro lip butter and the Laneige lip glowy balm. I hate that name, it doesn't make sense. But those two, those are probably my favorite kind of daily lip balms if I'm not going for a full-on mask. And in each of them, you get a ton more product and they are a ton less expensive. So I don't think I would purchase these again just for the lip balm formula. I mean, the shades are kind of cool. It's kind of gimmicky. Like a gray lip balm, you're like, oh, how can that look good? And then it's just clear. So these, they're very hydrating while the product is on, and they're very comfortable while the product is on. But once it comes off, I just feel like I have to reapply lip balm right again. Whereas my Sol de Janeiro lip butter, that one I can wear and then my lips still feel really soft even after the product is worn off. I don't feel like I have to reapply a lip balm again. For me, I don't think I would purchase another one of these in the future just because it is a lot of money and I have a lot of other lip balms that I like better. And it's a lot of money. Did I already say that? It's not even that it's a lot of money. It's just that the price compared with how hydrating the lip balm is, it's just average. So like, I won't be reaching for these for my daily lip balms because I do have other ones that I like better. I do think the blue glitter in the Astral Blue Star is cool. Whether or not you want to spend the money on that, that's your call though. For Noir though, it's literally just a clear average lip balm that cost me $56. So I'm not trying to bash these. I wanted to try the formula, and these two shades came out at the same time that I discovered it. So I was like, well, I'll just try these ones. And the formula's okay. It's not horrible. It's not amazing though. Anyways, that's all I have for today's video. Thanks so much for watching and I will see you later. Bye.